Hello guys, welcome back to another episode here on European Confessions. There is a message that I want to share with you guys, and this message, it comes from a translation of a message that I received, and the translation of that message reads like this. Hello my brother, how are you? Can you please post my own story as hidden identity? So when I came here to South Africa, I then met this other lady. She was also from Zim, even though we were staying as husband and wife, but we were not legally or culturally married. I had not yet managed to go and pay up for her bride price. It then happened that in the area where me and this woman were staying, there was this other guy. So this guy, he comes from a certain part of Africa, and I do not want to mention the name of that country from where he comes from. This guy, I then started to see that he never went to work and he never did anything, but he was living a very good soft life, and at that time he had recently bought this other Range Rover that he was driving. So I fell in love with this car. So I then thought that a lot of people, they say that your friends are the ones that can make you succeed or fail in life. I then said that instead of me hanging around poor people like me, it was far much better to hang around this brother from another mother. So each and every time over the weekends, I would go over to his apartment. This guy, he was using me a lot and he was not paying me anything, but I said, this is the price that I have to pay so that I can get to hang around rich people. And I kept on praying that one day will be one day, this guy, he was going to connect me with his rich friends. Usually what I would do, this guy, since he had seen that I was really desperate to become as rich as he was, he would tell me that I had to wash his clothes, and he would say that I needed to wash his car whenever he would go to the clubs. So the clubs that these guys have is that they do not want to mix and mingle with local men. They just want the local South African ladies in those VIP clubs. As for the men, they only allow men from their own country. So each and every time that you would bring me into that club, I would be the one who would have to drive him back to the place, since I had a driver's license. So I was now working like his own private driver. My wife, each and every time when I would return back home late, she would always complain, and she would say that, what is the purpose of me hanging around this guy? I was being used and this guy was not paying me anything. But I was telling myself that this was just a price that I had to pay so that I can get rich in life. This guy, one day when we went to the club, he kept on saying that he wanted to meet this other spiritual father of his. And I want people to be very careful whenever you hear someone saying that he has his own spiritual father, he or she has a spiritual father. You need to be very careful, because when one say that they have a spiritual father, it does not automatically mean that the spiritual father is a pastor or a bishop, because you never know. So when we went to the club on that day, that spiritual father came, and when I looked at the man who was said to be the spiritual father, this man, he seemed like someone who had came out of a movie. He came into the club and they started speaking. Later on, I was called so that I can come and join them. So we then started following the convoy of cars which had that spiritual father. We drove and we drove until we had entered into the estates, whereby no one is not even allowed to enter in those type of estates. When we arrived at that spiritual father's place, I saw that this place, it was just a house whereby they were using it to perform their rituals. I was then introduced to this brotherhood. This man said that I could be trusted because I was not a local and I was from Zim. That is how I ended up joining into that brotherhood. When I joined into this brotherhood, I was made to go and sleep inside a coffin. And what surprised me is that when they took me so that I can go and sleep inside a coffin, I thought that this was my death, because I actually had these men as they had placed me inside that coffin. I had these guys as they were screwing some screws into that coffin which they had placed me into. And I told myself that this was my end, and my end had just arrived, and I was about to die. But I kept on breathing, even though they had locked me up inside that coffin. I never suffocated like I thought that I would end up doing. After that, they removed me from that coffin, and they told me that there were more rituals that we were supposed to perform. So the other rituals that we performed, my brother, is that I was then taken to this other house. Which direction we took when we came from that estate, I can't even remember anymore. All that I know is that we drove and we drove until we had gone to this remote area. And to my surprise, when we were in that remote area, when I looked around the next day when we came out of that mansion, I saw that this beautiful mansion, it was just in the middle of nowhere. So I do not know if this mansion is inside a game park or what, because when I looked for miles and miles, I could not see anything. I didn't see any houses. I never saw any cars. It was just in a remote area. Then what happened is that this man then told me that I had to be washed clean, and they took this other 20 liter bucket, and this 20 liter bucket, it was not filled with water, but it was filled with blood. When I saw that this 20 liter bucket that had been given to me, it was full of blood, I got so scared. Then that spiritual father said that I should not be afraid, because this blood that was inside that 20 liter bucket, it was the blood that belonged to chickens. So my question is, my brother, how many chickens do you have to slaughter so that you can fill up a 20 liter bucket with chicken blood? They gave me the blood and they told me that I had to wash myself. After washing myself, they told me that I had to go and sit in the sun. So I went outside and I sat. My brother, it was really hot. And one thing about blood is that the more that it gets dry on your skin, the more that it becomes painful. Throughout the day, I was not allowed to drink water. I was not allowed to eat anything. After that, I was then taken into the brotherhood. I was told that when they made me to go inside that coffin, what was happening is that I had gone and I had met death, and I had sacrificed my own soul so that I can be given the riches that are there in this world. So I had sold my soul, and which means that I am going to be living a very comfortable life whilst I am still alive. Then one day death will come to collect my soul, and there is nothing that I will be able to do about it. When I returned back, I was then told that I was supposed to sacrifice my own wife. I said, why do I have to sacrifice my own wife? And I didn't even know that there was more sacrifices that was needed, because the first time when we had gone to that estate, I asked, is these things of me joining this brotherhood, is it going to require blood? Those men, they just laughed and no one ever answered me. The next time around, I was told that the blood of that woman that I was staying with, her blood was needed. I was really scared, because when they mentioned the blood, I thought that it was physical blood. I said, I do not want to kill anyone. I do not want to be in trouble with the police. Then I was told that there were some items that were going to be given to me, and these items that were going to be given to me, they were going to be used so that my wife's blood can be harvested. So there was these other herbs that I had to wait for. These herbs, my brother, they were coming from India. So I waited for many days whilst those herbs were still there in India when they did that order. Finally, those herbs came. When they came, I was made to drink those herbs, and they were so bitter to taste. After I had drank them, I was then told that I was supposed to go and sleep with my wife, and when I'll be sleeping with my wife, there was sort of like a demonic spirit that was going to enter into her womb, and she was going to think that she was pregnant. Even if we would go to the doctors would actually see that there was a baby that was growing inside a womb, but this was just a demonic spirit, nothing else. After that, I slept with my wife. Then later on, she told me that she had missed her periods, and this meant that she was pregnant. My wife, she carried that pregnancy, and just like what I had been told, she died whilst she was in labor, because the oath that they had placed down like a curse was that if she was going to be taken to the theater room, she was never going to make it out of the theater room, because her blood was going to be harvested whilst the doctors were operating on her. So when they took her inside that theater room for her to be operated on, I knew that she was going to meet death, and that spiritual master went and collected her blood. I had also given her some rings, and these rings that I had given her when she was still alive, I had been told that even though I was still poor at that time, I had not yet been given my money. I was told that I had to use my own hard-earned money and to buy the most expensive rings that I could afford. So I had gone and I had purchased those rings, and I had gotten engaged to my wife. And me getting engaged to my wife, they said that this was supposed to be done so that our relationship can be recognized in the spiritual realm. When I gave her the ring, this meant that even in the spiritual realm, she was now recognized as my partner. So it was possible for me now to sacrifice her soul. I had also been given another ring with a small emerald. And this ring, my brother, after I had started going around to different expensive restaurants, I swear to you that I have met men and I have met women that are really wealthy, and one thing that I have recognized about them is that they wear this same kind of rings that was given to me, the ones with a small emerald on it. Some of them, they are locals, and I have met men that are from Zim that are also involved in these occultic practices. My wife, when she was still alive, after I had given her that ring, then the ring just disappeared. One night we woke up and the ring was missing on her fingers. Even though I acted as if I was surprised, but I knew everything that was going on. The ring had been taken as a token of my sacrifice to the brotherhood. When my wife passed away, her relatives then came and collected her body, because they saw that even if they wanted to refuse to collect their beloved deceased body, I could not even afford to get her back to Zim, since I was still struggling. But now that I am making money, sometimes I think that it is far. But after I had started making money, I then returned back home and I bought them a little bit of things. And what I bought for them, even though I cannot say it in public, because I am afraid that the moment that I am going to mention everything that I did for them, maybe there will be someone who will know my story. So I just gave them a little bit of something, and this was like me thanking their daughter for the sacrifice that she did for me. After she had been buried, then money started flowing in, and right now I can say that I am a man who is living a very comfortable life. Dear listeners, right there was a narration of a message that I received.